University of Sousse from Tunisia. I didn't get to speak to the world, but I'm going to bring the word of one person from my research unit, Dr. Lydia Shinti-Mahadi with Dr. Sonia Ali-Shiramushi from the IDA Research Laboratory. The work is entitled An Instructional Design Approach for E-Active Cards. We will start with a brief introduction to the general context. Then I will go to the mental model for instructional design process of active e-courses. This will bring me to the process description of meta-instructional design, as well as the architecture of the authoring tool for active e-course, which is called ACID tool. And I will finish by a conclusion and some future work. Instructional design, as all of us know, concerns courses that can be based on various pedagogical approaches such as active learning, problem-based learning, inquiry-based learning. Active learning, however, is defined as a planned series of actions or events to invite the participant to process, apply, interact, and share experiences as part of the educational process. In order to implement instructional design of courses, we need some authoring tools. So to integrate an array of media to create professional and interactive training contents, to repurpose elements of learning objects from an existing course for use in a new one. The main actor in the instructional design is the instructional designer. We need models which can function as a visual and communication tool, so to help conceptualize complex schematics or instructional design process. In a previous research work, a meta model has been proposed by the same researchers, Dr. Lydia Shinti-Mahadi and Dr. Sonia Ali-Shiramushi. The meta model is composed of the main concepts that are needed in the transformation of active cars into an active e-course or electronic cars. During the instructional design, we need also to follow up a set of steps for our activities for transforming courses in their online versions. These steps, designed as activities, will need to be described through a meta model which will be presented in this work. In fact, active learning improves student attitudes and develops thinking and writing skills. It's more and more recommended as a teaching method to improve learning. As well, its proactive learning promotes problem solving, critical thinking, and manipulation of materials, synthesis and assessment of information. Active methodologies together with ICTs contribute to development of students' skills to actively research and undertake responsibility for their own learning process and to solve problems using their own resources. Models exist in literature about the way in which the instructional design of online courses must be realized. Nevertheless, these models generally don't consider courses based on active pedagogy. This brings us to the proposal of an instructional method that provides guidance for instructional designers to design an active e-course. We will describe the process of the instructional design process of an active e-course that will constitute the theoretical framework of an authoring tool. We will study the specificities of transforming a course based on active pedagogy in an online version and examine the effectiveness of using information and communication technologies in active learning, which is referred as active e-learning. For the meta model that is proposed, it aims to give a response to the question, which is how to provide a description of the steps for the instructional design of e-courses model, taking into consideration active pedagogy. The meta model that has been proposed is composed of four meta activities. The meta activity zero, which concerns the e-active model structuring. The meta activity one, which focuses on needs analysis. The meta-activity tool, which is interested in the instructional design, and the meta-activity three, which is focusing on implementation and evaluation. We will give a description of these four meta-activities. The main actors in the instructional design of e-courses are the meta-instructional designer. He defines the various types of instructional methods that can be adopted in an active e-course. The content expert, which prepare and deliver the content of an active e-course. The instructional designer, who designs the learning resources and activities received from the content expert and according to the structuring of active e-course previously prepared by the meta-instructional designer. The learner, which plays a central role in the active e-course, and the facilitator, which uses the available communication and assessment tools to ensure an efficient follow-up of the involved active learners. Here we have a global use case diagram for the active e-learning instructional design. We have five actors: the meta-instructional design, carries out the meta activity zero, which is the e-active model structure. The content expert, which has to carry out the meta activity one and participate to the meta activity two, the needs analyzed and the instructional design. The instructional designer, which will carry out the instructional design. And the learner, the facilitator, which will carry out the third meta activity, which is the implementation and the evaluation process. We have a detailed description of the meta-activity zero, which is the e-active model structuring. The main actor is the meta-instructional designer, who carry out, who define the types of instructional methods, as well as the types of resources and activities. He defines also the required skills and the types of tools. The meta-activity one is carried out by the content expert, which has to analyze the needs. He defines the learning objectives, the learner characteristics, sorry, and the instruments of assessment. The meta-activity two is the instructional design. It's carried out by the content expert and the instructional designer. The content expert has to design lessons and activities, content sequencing, as well as the assessment instruments. The instructional designer, however, has to design lessons and activities, the content sequencing, the assessment instructional design, and the design of the communication tools. The meta-activity 3 is the implementation and the evaluation. It's carried out by the instructional designer, the learner, and the facilitator. The instructional designer has to develop the active e-course. The learner has to elicitate his knowledge, to execute the active e-course process, and to do the active e-course revision. The facilitator has to help in executing the active e-course and revising this course. Here we have an activity diagram for needs analysis. The content expert will define the learning objectives in terms of global objectives as well as specific objectives. Then he will define the learner characteristics in terms of prerequisites and level of study. And he will finish by the assessment instruments definition, where he has to choose the type of assessment and the technique which will be used. Here we have the description of the architecture of the tool which is proposed. We have three main components. We have a database of pedagogical scenarios, available for the instructional for the instructional design to enable content sequencing and design of active e-cards. We have a database of resources and activities to be delivered by the content expert, and we have a base of generated active e-cards, which is accessible for learners and facilitators. Here are the main components of the framework. To conclude, the authors proposed a model of instructional design of e-active cards. They describe the meta activities in this meta model and their correspondent actors, as well as the detailed description of the various sub-activities that compose the process of meta instructional design through the activity diagrams. The objective of this theoretical framework is to design an opening tool for active e-courses that should be available for all involved actors. This tool is under implementation. For contacts, if you use Ms. Lilia Mabilqadi at fcon.rn.tv.